It's good to have all of you here again today.
很高兴今天在这里再一次看见大家。
Whether it's your first time to be with us, or if you've been here for many times, or maybe for all the 29 years, we are glad that you are here.
不管今天是你第一次来到我们中间，还是跟我们一起已经29年了，我们现在我们今天都欢迎大家。
Beginning next Sunday and for the next 5 Sundays after that, we will be in a sermon series called Countdown to Ascension, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, blast off.
从下个星期天开始，我们会开始一个系列的讲道，我把它称为升天的倒计时讲道，4, 3, 2, 1, 0，发射。
Just like there is a countdown when one of the rocket ships flies up into the atmosphere and then outer space, the first and second heaven, we're going to do like that. We're going to one day blast up out of the first and second atmosphere and then the space, and then we're going to go into the third heaven, the heaven where God is.
就好像火箭发射一样哈，的倒数，然后点火，这火箭就发射出去，到了我们所说的第一层天，甚至宇宙第二层天那里去一样。我们的经文，我们这一系列的讲道，但愿上帝借着经文把我们发射到他所在的，与他同在的第三层天。那里，
Jesus is already there. He is waiting on us. Actually, he's waiting for when he comes back to call us up to be with him.
主耶稣现在就是在那里，坐在父神的右边，他等待着要再来接我们的时间。
Let us bow our heads for prayer.
我们低头祷告。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for your precious word. 天父为了你的宝贵的话语，我们感谢你。We are thankful for you allowing us to understand how much you love us. 我们也感谢你，你让我们能够理解你有对我们有那么大的爱。And Father, you have also told us that we should love you and love one another. 也告诉我们应该爱你，也是彼此相爱。So Father, do your work in our lives. 天父，求你做你的圣工在我们的生命中。Help us today to honor you in all that we say and do. 帮助我们今天在所做的、所说的都能够得你的喜悦。In Jesus' name we pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求，Amen. The gospel writers devoted many pages to the events leading up to the crucifixion of Jesus Christ.
我们看圣经的福音书，发现福音书的作者用了很长的篇幅，去描述主耶稣被钉十字架前所发生的事。
The final week of Jesus' triumphal his of his life, his work here on earth, began with the triumphal entry into the city of Jerusalem. When people called out to him, Hosanna, just all of them crying out Hosanna, which means save us. They're expecting him to be their coming king to lead them to defeat the Roman enemy. But only a week later, they will cry out, the same crowd will cry out, crucify him, crucify him.
在主耶稣被钉的一个星期之前，他进入耶路撒冷的时候，福音书的作者已经详细描述，和耶路撒冷合城的人都欢迎他，他们高呼何塞纳。何塞纳就是现在就拯救的意思，但是同样的，这一群欢呼迎接耶稣的人，在一周之后，一同的呼喊着说：“钉死他，钉死他。”
Jesus apparently spent the most of the week that week in the temple teaching.
在那一周里面, 主耶稣, 花了大量的时间在圣殿里,
His evenings were spent in the home of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus in Bethany.
然后在晚上, 他是, 回到伯大尼的玛利亚, 马大以及拉撒路家里面过。
Significant events during the week include the plot of the Sanhedrin. That's the Supreme Court of the Jewish Jewish nation. They're plotting to kill Jesus.
这个那一个星期很重要的事情就是包括犹太人的公会怎样的商议要除灭耶稣。
It also included the betrayal of Jesus and his arrest.
当然也包括了耶稣的被出卖，以及他的被捕、被钉。
In that week, we will see the Jewish and the Roman trials.
我们在那一个星期里面也看到了主耶稣在犹太人的会堂和罗马的公堂。
We'll also see his journey down to Golgotha, going down the street that is known today as Via Dolorosa.
我们也看到他从耶路撒冷的大街，一直走到各个他的这一条路。今天我们称这条路叫苦路。
Then we will see his resurrection.
然后我们看到他的复活。
And then we read from the Bible that for 40 days he taught his disciples, he was with them, fellowshiped with them, and then he ascended back to be at God's right hand.
然后在他的复活之后有40天之久，我们 看到耶稣怎样的向门徒们显现，教导，以及引领他们。Another
description of that week goes like this.
然后，这个星期的描述一般是这样描述的。
On Sunday, we see Jesus' triumphal entry into the city of Jerusalem.
星期天我们看到耶稣的荣耀进城。On
Monday, he cleanses the temple and drives out the money changers.
然后在星期一，他洁净圣殿，推倒桌子，赶走兑换银钱的人。On
Thursday, the Sanhedrin, they challenged Jesus' authority to do that.
然后星期四的工会的人就质问耶稣，你凭什么权柄做这些事？On
Thursday, Jesus also foretold about the destruction of the temple and of his second coming.
在星期四，耶稣也预言了。 圣殿的被毁，以及他的第二次再来。On
Thursday evening, Mary anointed Jesus.
在那一天晚上，玛利亚拿了那一瓶极贵重的膏油，膏了耶稣。And
sometime during that day or that evening, Judas bargained with the Jewish rulers to betray Jesus.
然后在那一天的某个时候，犹大跟工会的人商议怎样的来出卖耶稣。Then
we see on that Thursday, Jesus ate the Passover with his disciples and instituted the Lord's Supper.
然后我们看见在周四的。 晚上，耶稣与他的门徒吃了逾越节的晚餐。
Afterwards, Jesus and his disciples, they went to the Garden of Gethsemane where Jesus prayed.
然后之后，耶稣和门徒们就去了克西马尼园，在那里耶稣祷告。
In the early hours of Friday, we see his betrayal and his arrest in the garden.
然后在周五的凌晨, 我们读到了耶稣被出卖, 他在园子里面被捕。
Jesus was taken to the home of Annas. Annas was the former high priest.
他们抓到了耶稣基督，就带他到当时的大祭司亚拿的家里，在那里审问他。
There he was interrogated.
因为他自己家是一个审犯人的地方。
Then Jesus was taken to the home of Caiaphas, the new high priest.
然后耶稣就被带到接下来新任的大祭司该亚法那里。
While Jesus was being falsely accused and interrogated, Peter denied Jesus three times.
当耶稣被私底下审问的时候，彼得三次不认主。
Then the Sanhedrin formally charged Jesus.
然后犹太人的公会正式的审判耶稣，定耶稣死罪。
Sometime around this time, Judas committed suicide.
在这一段时间里面的某一个时刻，犹大自杀。
Jesus was taken from the Sanhedrin and taken to Pilate, the Roman governor, for trial.
然后我们读到耶稣被押到衙门，就是罗马的这个官府比拉多那里。
Pilate did not want to take responsibility, so he sent Jesus to Herod Antipas.
所以比拉多审了之后，发现他不想管这件事，所以就把耶稣送到西律那里。But
Herod Antipas decided he didn't want to either and sent him back to Jesus. Or back to Pilate.
这个安提帕斯的西律接到了耶稣之后，发现算了，他也不想管这事儿，就把耶稣送回来，比拉多那里。Then
Pilate declared Jesus innocent, but he then also signed his death warrant, his crucifixion warrant, because he wanted to please the Jews.
比拉多宣告耶稣是没有罪的，但是他也被迫签了耶稣死刑的执行的文件，因为他要取悦犹太人，怕叛乱。Roman
soldiers mocked Jesus, they whipped him, and then they took him to Calvary and crucified him between two thieves.
罗马的士兵鞭打了耶稣，羞辱他，然后把他带到加略山，然后就在那里把他与另外两个犯人，强盗，一起钉了十字架。When
Jesus died, the sky darkened. The earth quaked, and the Bible tells us that the temple, the veil between the holy place and the holy of holies, it ripped from the top to the bottom.
当耶稣断气的时候，整个天空是黑暗的， 地是震动的，然后圣殿里面分开圣所和至圣所之间的幔子从上到下裂成两半。
Jesus' dead body was taken off of the cross, and he was buried in the tomb of Joseph of Arimathea.
耶稣的身体被从十字架上取下来之后，是被安放在约瑟亚利马太的约瑟这个财主的坟墓里。
Saturday arrived and it was the Sabbath.
然后星期六到了，那是安息日。
But praise God, on Sunday, Jesus rose from the grave.
感谢神，星期天的清晨，耶稣复活。
That's an overview of what took place that week, that last week when Jesus was here ministering.
以上就是对于耶稣基督被钉十字架那一个星期的一个概括的论述。
Today I want to just briefly introduce the people that are involved in the actual arrest of Jesus.
而今天我们想说的，想介绍的是在耶稣基督被捕的时候那个故事里面的几个重要的人物，想跟大家先说一下。
The title today is For the Arrest Part 1.
今天我们的题目是耶稣基督的被捕，然后第一部分。
So the four is there because next week will be for the second part, and then 3, 2, 1, and then blast off.
然后这是第一部分，然后从下个星期开始就是第二部分，然后还记得吗？4, 3, 2, 1, 0，就发射。
So let's first look at Judas.
我们今天看的第一个人物是犹大。
John chapter 18, verses 1 and 2.
约翰福音十八章一到二节。
When Jesus had spoken, why don't you just read with me? That'd be good. When Jesus had spoken these words, he went forth with his disciples over the brook Kedron, where was a garden, into the which he entered, and his disciples.
约翰福音十八章一到二节，请大家的对着屏幕和我一起读。耶稣说了这话，就同门徒出去，过了吉伦西，在那里有一个园子，他和门徒进去了。
And Judas also, which betrayed him, knew the place, for Jesus oft time resorted thither with his disciples.
卖耶稣的犹大也知道那地方，因为耶稣和门徒屡次上那里去聚集。
If you look up the name Judas and try to find people with that name, it was a very popular name. There are many people in the Bible named Judah or Judas.
如果大家在圣经里面查找的话，发现圣经里面挺多人叫犹大的，很著名的一个名字。
The name Judas was a popular name until Judas Iscariot tarnished it beyond repair.
这个犹大这个名字一直在犹太人当中非常普遍，很多人都取这个名字，只等到这个加勒人犹大之后，就没有人再起这个名字了。
Now, when we hear that name, we automatically think of traitor.
今天如果在英文的世界里面，甚至中文的世界里面，你提到犹大这个字的话，人们马上就想到叛徒，两个字。
He betrayed the sinless, perfect Son of God for 30 pieces of silver.
他为着30块银钱出卖了没有罪的上帝的儿子耶稣。
Judas was a hypocrite.
犹大是一个假冒伪善的人。
He was clever. Nobody ever found him out, but Jesus knew all along.
他也很聪明，没有人知道他是这样的一个人，但是主耶稣从一开始就知道。
He acted like a believer, but he really wasn't.
他的举动都像一个信了的人，但是他并没有。
He traveled with Jesus. He heard all of the marvelous message and teaching of Jesus. He saw all of the miracles that Jesus did, but was looking for a savior that would rid Israel of the hated Romans. That's what he was looking for.
他跟耶稣在一起很长的时间, 他听过耶稣那一些非常 令人惊讶的讲论，他也亲眼看过主耶稣所有的神迹，但是他等待的，他想要找的是一个把以色列从罗马手中夺回来的王。He
was not looking for a savior that would die for his sins.
他不是在等待一位
When Jesus did not meet his expectations, he became disillusioned.
当耶稣并没有达到他的这个期望的时候，他就不抱任何幻想了。The
Bible says he was a thief.
圣经还提到他是一个贼。
I'm not sure exactly what was meant by that, but because he was the treasure of the apostles, it probably had something to do with embezzlement.
具体是什么事件我不是太清楚，但是圣经记载他是管理，他是主耶稣和他的门徒们的司库。 他是负责钱的，手拿钱袋的，所以这个很可能是跟挪用公款有关。I
am sure of several things, though.
但是有几件事情我是清楚的。He
made a deal to betray Jesus.
他跟犹太人的工会商议，卖了耶稣。
He knew where to lead the soldiers because he knew where Jesus usually went.
他带着人去抓耶稣，因为想抓耶稣的人不知道耶稣在哪。He
betrayed Jesus with a kiss.
他背叛耶稣是用一个吻来出卖耶稣，让抓他的人知道他是谁的。And
I know that he committed suicide.
然后我知道他最后是自杀的。He
killed himself.
他把自己的生命结束了。Someone
has remarked, Judas kissed the door of heaven, but then went to hell.
有人说犹大吻了天堂的门，然后去地狱了。Now
let us consider the soldiers.
好，我们再看另外的人物，那一些士兵们。John
chapter 18 verse
3. 对，我继续读第三节，约翰福音十八节，十八章。Judas
then having received a band of men and officers from the chief priests and Pharisees, cometh thither with lanterns and torches and weapons.
犹大领了一队兵。 和祭司长并法利赛人的差役，拿着灯笼、火把、兵器，就来到园里。In
the Gospel of Luke, the band of officers and men are called a multitude.
在路加福音记载这一队兵的时候，路加用的词描述是一大队兵。
In Matthew, they are called a great multitude.
然后的马太也说了，是一队很大的兵。
The meaning is they were. It was a large group of soldiers.
所以来抓耶稣的兵丁，不是几个人、十几个人，是一大队的兵。
They were armed and they were ready for battle.
而且这一队兵是带着兵器的，他们认为可能要有仗要打。
They arrested Jesus and took him away.
他们把耶稣抓了，就把他带走。
They obeyed their orders without any feeling, without any pity upon Jesus.
他们只是奉命行事，对耶稣没有任何的怜悯。
Now let's think about Jesus.
然后我们看今天故事的第三个人物。耶稣
We're going to look at John chapter 18, verses 4 to 9.
马太福音，约翰福音第十八章，我们继续看第四到第九节。
Let's look at verse 4 first. Jesus, therefore, knowing all things that should come upon him, went forth and said unto them, Whom seek ye?
耶稣知道将要临到自己的一切事，就出来对他们说，你们找谁？
Jesus knew that they were coming. He knew all things, but he did not run and hide.
主耶稣知道他们来抓他，但是主耶稣也知道事情，什么事情要成就，所以他没有逃跑躲起来。
He went out to Judas and the soldiers.
他走出去，正面面对，犹大以及那一大队的兵。
Jesus had been earnestly praying in the garden. We've studied about that many times. And he is now ready to fulfill his purpose for the purpose of coming to this earth.
我们之前也很多次看过耶稣在客西马尼园的祷告。他祷告完了，他也预备好了。他那个非常恳切的祷告我们都记得。然后他已经预备好面对他要面对的事情。
Jesus asked the question, Whom seek you?
耶稣问这一大队的兵说你们找谁？
Verses 5 and 6, we see the answer.
我们看第五到第六节他们的回答。
They answered him, Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus saith unto them, I am he.And Judas also, which betrayed him, stood with them.
他们回答说，找拿撒勒人耶稣。耶稣说，我就是。卖他的犹大也同他们站在那里。
And we have a mystery in verse 6. It says, as soon then as he had said unto them, I am he, they went backward and fell to the ground.
十八章第六节，耶稣一说“我就是”，他们就退后，倒在地上。
Verse 6 says they went backward and fell to the ground.
他们退后，就倒在地上了。
Could it be that the sudden power and the power of God of God's word through Jesus, just temporarily unnerved them, and they fell to the ground.
会不会是的从耶稣而出来的能力，一下子震惊了他们，他们就倒在地上呢？还是什么回事
？Or were they falling back in defensive posture, anticipating an attack from Jesus' disciples?
他们退后倒在地上，也就代表着他们之前想扑上来，对耶稣和他的门徒。
Why they fell back is a mystery.
这个他们怎么个退后，倒在地上呢？是一个很那个是一个谜啊。
But we know that Jesus came to give his life for our sins.
但是我们知道从 这时开始，耶稣就预备好，把自己的性命交付给人。
We know no one took his life from him.
我们知道没有人夺取他的性命。
He freely gave his life to pay for the sin debt that we owed.
是他自己愿意舍的，为付我们的罪债而舍。
Let's look at verse 7.
我们来看第七节。
Then asked he them again, Whom seek ye? And they said, Jesus of Nazareth.
他又问他们说，你们找谁？ 他们说，找拿撒勒人耶稣。
Verse 8 says, Jesus answered, I have told you that I am he. If therefore ye seek me, let these go their way.
耶稣说，我已经告诉你们，我就是。你们若找我， 就让这些人去吧。Verse
9 says, that the saying might be fulfilled which he spake, of them which thou givest me have I lost none.
这要应验耶稣从前的话说，你所赐给我的人，我没有失落一个。That
phrase right there says, of them which thou givest me have I lost none. Is part of his prayer that was recorded in the 17th chapter of John.
在这一章，在我们正在读的是《约翰福音》18章，在之前一章17章，耶稣祷告，里面就有这样的一句，父神赐给他的一个都没有失落。
Jesus protected his disciples. He made sure that the disciples were not arrested with him.
主耶稣保护他的门徒，他叫这些士兵，我就是不要让这一些人去吧，不要抓他们。We
have one more person to look at, and his name is Peter.
我们今天还有另外一个人也要来一起来看，就是西门彼得。He's
found in verse 10 and 11.
我们在第十和第十一节读到他。Verse
10 says, Then Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and smote the high priest's servant and cut off his right ear. The servant's name was Malchus.
西门彼得带着一把刀就拔出来，将大祭司的仆人砍了一刀，削掉他的右耳。那仆人名叫马勒古。Then
said Jesus unto Peter, Put up thy sword in the sheath. The cup which my Father hath given me, should I not drink it?
耶稣就对彼得说：“收刀入鞘吧。” 我父所给我的那杯，我岂可不喝呢？
Peter's original name was not Peter. His name was Simon.
彼得的名字，他叫西门。
As we read about him and look at him and see what he did, we find out that he was impetuous, impulsive, and overeager.
彼得，如果我们从福音书的经文来看的话，我们会发现他是一个冲动的人，那个也是很热情的一个人，但是非常冲动，鲁莽。Simon
often spoke before he thought.
西门总是没有想好之前，他就已经把自己的
Jesus had to rebuke him several times for this.
因为他说话不经大脑，主耶稣有好几次责备他的。He
also often acted impulsively and before he began to think of what he's really doing.
他不单只说话没经过大脑，有时候做事也没有经过大脑。
One day Jesus said, I'm going to change your name. I'm going to change your name from Simon. I'm going to name you Peter.
主耶稣有一天对他说，你叫西门，但是你的名字要叫彼得。
Peter means rock.
彼得的意思是石头。
A rock is steadfast and strong.
石头是坚硬的，是坚固的。
That was Jesus' perfect will for Simon, what he wanted Simon to become.
这是主耶稣愿盼望耶稣这是主耶稣盼望彼得成为的一个人的样式。
But often Peter would revert back to Simon.
我们看到彼得身上的一件事。
He would start acting like Simon instead of like Peter the Rock.
你看到他的冲动就好像西门的样子，一点彼得的样子都没有，就是石头的样子，坚固坚定的样子都没有。
A good example is when Judas and the multitude came to arrest Jesus.
当犹大带着这一大队兵来抓耶稣的时候，你看到彼得的反应。
The book of Luke reveals that when the disciples saw the soldiers coming, they asked Jesus, should we fight?
在路加福音记载门徒们看见这一大队人来的时候曾经也问过耶稣说我们跟他们打吗？
But before Jesus could answer, Peter had already drawn his sword and cut off the ear of the high priest's servant.
但是主耶稣都还没有告诉他们应该怎么做之前，彼得已经冲过去砍了这一刀了。
Jesus indicated that they should not resist. Then he rebuked Peter. And then, the Bible says, he healed the ear of the servant.
路加福音记载，主耶稣制止他们说，不要跟他们对抗。路加福音呢，十二章说，主耶稣也治好了那个人的耳朵。
Once again that night, Peter would revert back to Simon.
所以我们看到那天晚上彼得其实像西门而不像彼得也就是石头的意思。
He who had vowed he would die before he forsook Jesus, ultimately he denied Jesus three times.
那天晚上他曾经跟耶稣说我就算与你同死也愿意，结果三次不认耶稣。
He was so humiliated, he was so sorrowful, and that loving forgiveness that Jesus gave to him permanently changed Simon into Peter.
他非常的羞愧他非常他非常的羞愧，但是耶稣基督对他的饶恕以及安慰终于使西门变成了彼得。
Next week we are going to look deeper into the arrest of Jesus.
我们下个星期再继续看耶稣的被捕。
But right now, I want to ask you, do you identify with some of these people?
但是现在我们就停在这里。我有几个问题要问。今天所说的几个人，你都看得出来吗？
Do you identify with Judas?
你能辨认出犹大吗？
Are you looking for a savior who will bless you physically and make you rich and famous?
你是在寻找一个救主，是赐给你肉身上的财富，以及名誉的吗？
Do you identify with the soldiers?
你能辨认出那一些的士兵吗？
Are you just trying to follow orders and get by the best you can, but you have no concept about a Savior who died for your sins?
你是一个像这些士兵一样，就按照给你的指令去做，只是谋生而已啊！想那么多干嘛？从来没想过一位救主吗？
Let me ask you, what do you think of Jesus?
那关于第三个人物，你怎么来看第三个人物耶稣的？
Is he a man, or is he the Son of God who loves you and gave his life to provide you with eternal life?
这个耶稣他是一个人呢，还是一位神的儿子？他爱你。 不惜将自己的生命摆上，也要为你，成就永生呢？
What about Peter?
然后你能辨别出彼得西门彼得吗？
Can you see a little bit of yourself in Peter?
你在彼得的里面看见你自己的身影吗？
Or Simon?
是西门的身影还是彼得的身影？
Are you impetuous, impulsive, and overeager like Simon?
你有没有鲁莽、冲动，或者过于热切的像西门一样呢？
You speak and act before you really think.
你。 在没有想好之前就说话了。Or
are you like Peter? Like Peter, you are steadfast and dependable.
还是你像彼得，也就是石头那样子的坚固和稳定呢？可以依靠呢？
How you answer these questions can make a big difference in this life and in the life to come.
你怎样回答这些问题，对你来说可以，使你的生命，被有很大的影响，对你这一生和来生都会有影响。Would
you bow your heads for prayer?
我们低头祷告。Heavenly
Father, we thank you for allowing us to understand what took place when Jesus was arrested. 天父，我们感谢你，你给我们机会能够理解耶稣被抓的时候的情况。You let us understand some of the people that were involved. 你让我们能够也看到跟这个事有关系的。And Lord, you allow us to see some things that might benefit us, either things we should do or shouldn't do. 你让我们也能够理解有一些该做的或是不该做的。 Father, help us to learn our lessons well. 天父，求你让我们做好学生。And Lord, we pray today that you will guide us to come to you in faith. 我们盼望你能够带领我们，引导我们，能够靠信心到你的面前。Lord, there may be Christians here that are more like Simon than Peter. 可能有一些基督徒是比较像西门，不像彼得。Lord, help us to be strong. 天父求你让我们变成刚强的。Help us to be steady. 帮助我们稳定下来。 Help us to follow you all the days of our life. 帮助我们一辈子的跟随你。 Lord, there may be some that are like the soldiers or some like Judas. They're looking for something different or doing something different. They have no idea that Jesus is the Son of God. 他们的想法是像那个 军队，也是可能是像犹大，他们不知道 你是谁。I pray, Lord, that you would speak to their hearts. May the Holy Spirit help them understand who you are and what their need is. 我求你的圣灵能够让他们理解你是谁，也是让他们知道他们需要做什么。In Jesus' name I pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求。Amen.
Amen.
If you have questions or if you have prayer requests, please contact us using the information on the screen. May God bless you. And don't forget, next week, we're continuing on with the series. Don't miss a single one or you will miss part of the story.
在屏幕上面你可以看到我们的联系方式。如果你有代祷事项或者需要请选择一个屏幕上的任何一个途径来联系我们。再一次提醒大家，我们的五部的系列的讲道，请大家从下个星期天开始一个星期天都不要落下，否则你就会缺失了故事里面的一部分。
Father, we ask you to prepare our hearts to remember that Jesus not only died on the cross for our sins, but that he was buried, and that on the third day he rose again. 天父求你让我们能够准备我们的心，为了我们能够纪念耶稣为我们钉十字架，为我们死，也是在第三天后他从死里复活，让我们也知道40天后他都回天。我就是求你让我们能够一天一天赞美荣耀你。Lord, help us remember that 40 days later, Jesus went back to heaven. Help us every day to remember and to praise him. In Jesus' name we pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求。Amen.
Amen.